Hi, I didn't have time to put any makeup on or do my hair. I'm very sorry, I apologize. Being really quick about motivation in dance, and I consider myself a choreographer. I am a very specific type of choreographer, I'd like to think, because I am not trained academically. I have a very vivid imagination and very visual mind, as well as a very musical mind. So combined together, it's very powerful, but I do have to pace myself and find ways of conveying choreography, which means most of the time I'll either sketch or video myself. Just a bit of introduction, but what I dislike, basically, I'm going to start with this, is dancers who don't actually try to put any feeling or any thought into the process of creating a pattern of movement. Dancers who just turn up and do what I call a gym class type of dance, whether you're doing jazz or belly dance, or I'm going to take the example of salsa. I don't know about ballet much, but basically, I believe that you should really do something with your mind and your heart if you're going to dance at all. I mean, dancing is a bit like acting. If you're going to dance, you really should consider motivation of movement. Why are you extending your arm in that way? Why are you moving your shoulders in that way? In belly dance, which is full of prejudices, there is so much expression. And you're moving a hip in a certain way, you're extending your chest at the same time, you're extending your arm in a certain way, you're pointing your fingers in Eastern dance, finger extensions, and as well as toe extensions are very important. Middle Eastern as well as Indian, for instance, dancers. Why are these movements there? Why are you taking a step to the side in that fashion? Why are you curving your hip at the same time? What are you conveying? What are you saying? I hate it when dancers just turn up and just deliver the goods. This is what I've learned. This is the choreography. This is it. Whether you like it or not, I'm going to put a great costume. I'm going to do great choreography, but I don't have a person inside of the box. I don't have any attention to what the dance is. I don't have any personality, and I'm square and perfect on technique, but I don't know what I'm doing and why I'm doing it. I'm following a choreography, and look, I'm turning right, and look, I'm counting 1 to 4 very nicely, and now, like a robot, I turn around and I'm doing something with my chest. I'm doing a chest shimmy, and I'm doing it very well, but I don't know why it's there. What does it mean? What personality am I taking this dance to? Who am I when I'm doing something with my arms, when I'm doing something with my hips, when I'm doing something, in a certain way? Am I supposed to be sassy? Am I supposed to be seductive? Am I slightly aggressive? Am I full of pain? Is this tension meaning something? I don't know why dancers don't pay attention to that so much. And a lot of dancers just turn up and do their job of looking nice and doing a square choreography fantastically, but don't have the mission of like bringing something to stage. I really can't understand this. I can't understand this for the life of me. If you're doing dance, it's probably because you love the art. Shoot, how about that? Show the world why you're doing it. Show your audience why you're doing it. Every actor is going to go through Stanislavski if you do method acting, and Stanislavski is going to tell you, look, you should move from within. You don't just copy an action. You enter right, you enter left, you exit right, you exit left. You look at the audience in a certain way, you put that angle, you say something, you negate something, you refuse something, you move in a certain way as a chorus because you have a motivation behind it. It's the same for dance. And I don't know if this concept is really acknowledged. I don't know if it's acknowledged at all. I see, obviously in ballet, I suppose it's a bit more powerful, or if you're gonna have something like flamenco, or if you have something expressive like some kind of contemporary choreography or jazz, people will tend to have more expression. This hair is a joke. I would welcome comments, but I'm fed up with people putting comments on my channel about how I should do stuff with my stomach, or how, I don't know, they don't like what I'm talking about, one racial or cultural thing or another. They don't like it and they put nasty comments and I can't deal with it. So if you want to contact me about this, if you can contact me from my website. Anyway, I teach dance in London. I like to perform and I like to express myself. I suppose I'm the other extreme. I'm not so much somebody who likes to follow a choreography. I like to improvise more, but I also like to find expressive ways of conveying messages with accessories like veils or Isis wings or fan veils. Things with cloth usually are extensions of the body, and I love to explore that. I love to go into the air and then create sinuous shapes. And then you have another dimension, or several added dimensions to the silhouette. Some dancers like to work more on choreography and technique, and they do a great job only if they add the sincerity and the vibe, the intention, and what I call motivation. That makes sense. I've started directing a bit. I like to direct people, but I wish dancers would pay attention to that more instead of being vain and just polishing their shoes and shining in front of people. That's not what dance is about. Yes, looking beautiful and professional, depending on the style of performances you're doing. But if you're gonna do something, you might as well do it well. You might as well, especially if you've got something like a classic Egyptian style, or even if you have drum solo. I hate when people just do drum solo like some kind of copy and paste stuff. And it's a succession of isolations, but drum solo is also around interacting with people and being cheeky and being having a personality and humor. And if you don't have a motivation, like every hip drop should have some kind of, it's not just a doom, it's not just a tack for a movement, a smaller movement. You're there for a reason, and you represent something. You represent some kind of thing for you, from yourself, inside yourself. You represent yourself, but you also represent, that's why people identify to you as a performer. You represent some kind of conscious, subconscious collective. So you want to convey that. You're not there to shine in a nice bejeweled costume. That's not just why you're there. People want to recognize themselves, so you want to have a phrase, a sentence, some kind of thing, a paragraph, and then improvise maybe more or less depending on the interaction you're doing or where you're doing it. You have to have that power of, being able to react with people, but also react with yourself, react with your environment, and react with the music. And why is that composition, even if it's a drum solo, it's a composition. Why is it faster there? Why does it have a certain title like I Miss You or When You're Away? Why does it have a name of a lady there? Why is the composer giving this a title? Because he was thinking of illustrating somebody there with their personality and their talents, their threads. So in effect, you really are building a life story with your body and your mind. You are putting a voice to the character with your choreography, with your costume, whatever the costume reflects, if it's yellow or if it's gold, if it's blue, it might evocate the sea, serenity, it might be brash, it might be a bit tacky, it might be romantic. You are putting the dream to life. You are creating make-believe. And I don't understand why dancers will not do that. It is a lazy, emotionally lazy way out of creating properly. I hope you get inspiration from this. I wish I could sort of workshop a bit more with some of the dancers, mixed with contemporary, mixed with ballet, and mixed with jazz, dance theater shows on stage. And I hope I can do that when I have a bit more budget with my company, Red Glass Sky Dance. Yeah. Have a good one. If you want to contact me, please do it via my website. Thank you. Bye-bye. Keep dancing.